one thing siguro, for your audience to understand you, you owe them an explanation, I think. Di ba? You owe them an explanation of what your product or your brand is all about. Kasi if you're just selling this for the sake of selling and it doesn't ring a chord with them, strike a chord with them, parang they won't end up buying it. Or they would buy like one shirt and then forget about you and move on to the next brand.
Hey guys, welcome to another video and welcome to the lunch break. I'm your host Nicolo Nimor from Nick Automatic, and for this lunch break it's a little bit different because we have one of the biggest heavy metal band vocalists in the Philippines, and they're making a lot of influence to the heavy metal industry in the Philippines right now. Guys, let's welcome Rogel Simon of Valley of Chrome. Yung topic na ano eh, yung gusto kong pag-usapan sana natin is it's a little bit close to what we're talking about, heavy metal and music and everything. So I just wanted to talk about this topic in a bigger picture, which is how heavy metal influenced many industries. Baka may thoughts ka nito.
Well, ano, siguro parang ang pinaka-influential talaga sa metal na nakapag nadala siya sa mainstream is yung tipong hindi lang mainstream music scene, kumbaga being a part of pop culture is Metallica, kumbaga ilang beses na nagamit yung music nila for movies, tapos kumbaga kahit mga bata ngayon, 'di ba? Tanungin mo kung ano ang metal band, 'di ba? Alam nila eh, Metallica favorite ni Daddy 'yan eh. Mga 20 something sa kung nakakausap. Daddy ko ganito, favorite to. Nagpunta siya ng Metallica nung 90s, yung tumugtog sila dito sa Pilipinas. Kumbaga parang yun, that's one. Tapos siguro, in terms of, ano siguro, if you're asking industries, sa merchandising talaga, sila yung pinakamalakas eh. Parang the same route that Kiss did. Kumbaga, Kiss wasn't just a band eh. Kumbaga, it was, they say, a movement. Kiss Army, di ba? Parang, parang they released a lot of merchandise ranging from coffee mugs to backpacks to little kid stuff to action figures. Kumbaga, parang that's the enterprising side of rock music eh. Kiss isn't necessarily a metal band, pero Metallica siguro talaga. I have a few Metallica merchandise na hindi naman music related. Kumbaga, meron sa mga nilabas na mga baso, meron silang nilabas na carpet. Alam mo 'yun?
So parang, even towels, bath towels, maybe meron.
Towels, backpacks. Name it, probably they have it. I just have a couple of Metallica shirts here, pero 'di ba? Parang I also have action figures of Metallica and stuff like that. So parang if a band is immortalized onto action figures, that sums it up na parang hey, you're a big deal. Kumbaga, someone will sculpt you and immortalize you into something that people would buy. Parang that's every musician and artist's dream, 'di ba? Kumbaga, when the time comes that you have to, na parang shit, I did this, 'di ba? I did a lot and it still continues to influence people even if I'm not that active anymore or whatever, 'di ba? You're leaving a mark. That's right. basically that's the main goal, is not to stay in the radar forever, but let your works do. Kumbaga, it's not the face, it's what you say. It's not the imagery, it's what they feel. You're banking on the experience of this music, this performance, these songs that you create. So that vibe translates when someone sees your t-shirt, someone sees your product, he remembers your songs when he sees your product.
Yes.
Kumbaga, it's an experience basically. It's a 360 degree experience.
Actually, yun talaga yung na-learn ko recently. Para nabasa ko to, or I saw a video recently saying that about ano to, business na parang to get more sales, kailangan kukunin mo talaga yung emotion ng tao. Parang i-translate mo sa product mo, if emotional yung reaction nila, they would buy it. Because they are really passionate about the product and your brand. So, ganyan talaga yung positioning mo.
Halimbawa, when you see, dinalan akong kape. May kape ako, pare. Kape tayo.
Thanks.
Yan, thank you. So, yun.
I was saying na kapag mag-produce ka ng isang product or isa kang brand, kailangan ka talagang mag-position sa brand mo na may emotional feedback yung customers mo towards sa'yo. Kasi,
parang,
passionate
alam,
sila eh.
When you see a certain slogan, parang you don't need that many shirts, pero just because the slogan talks to you, dialogues with you, and you feel whatever said on the t-shirt, naglalabas ka talaga ng pere.
Exactly.
I like this. Parang, akong ako to.
Yes.
Oh, yun. So malakas yung ganun eh. Parang when you see a Metallica shirt saying, Kill 'Em All or Damage Incorporated, mga ganun, Harvester of Sorrow. Alam mo yung certain words that speak to a certain demographic na parang, I feel that.
Exactly. Yan. Yun yung pinaka-correct na definition.
Same thing rin with streetwear, di ba? When you see a slogan na gustong-gusto mo, even if it's just in plain text and it's printed on a Gildan shirt, parang supposed to be parang this just cheap product but it's priced for like, say what, 800. But then, hindi ka makaget over dun sa slogan, hindi ka makaget over dun sa symbolism na nasa shirt. Maglalabas ka talaga ng pera. I've been a consumer for so many years. I've spent so much money on merchandise. So I can really relate pagka ganun. Alam mo yun? That's why I'm so happy when I see someone rocking our merch or quoting lines from our songs. Especially me, kasi ako gumagawa ng lyrics nun. So when someone quotes my lyrics, alam mo yun? Parang it's the same thing as them buying the shirt. Kumbaga sinasa buhay nila yung less kasi ako sa imagery, alam mo yun? Parang I'd rather have someone who likes my band talk about my lyrics than talk about where did you buy this? Ano yung suot mo? Saan mo inano yan? Ayun.
Yung funny thing din kasi nung Campbell days dati. Kaya mabenta din yung Campbell dati kasi sa merch din namin. Baliktad din kami kasi of course ako gumagawa ako ng merchandise. So kami din yung gumagawa ng sobrang vibrant na mga designs dati for metal. So parang, where did you get that shirt? Ano yung Campbell? Then they listen to Campbell. So baliktad din kami dati. So it's just funny thinking about it.
Naalala ko pa yun eh.
So yeah, yun. Yeah. So, parang papunta na tayo sa topic na yung parang merchandise and mga t-shirts, ganun. There's one question talaga na kasi nakikita ko sa'yo na you've been collecting Nike shoes, SBs, di ba? Noon pa dati, MySpace days, nakikita ko yan sa feed
MySpace
mo dati.
MySpace days pa.
Until now, siguro, nakikita ko pa yung you've been collecting shoes, collecting streetwear stuff. So, I want to talk about it. So, what do you think about heavy metal influencing the streetwear industry today?
Kumbaga, parang ito yun eh. These kids that listen to metal during the popular years of these bands are now adults. And these are adults who want product na pinapangarap nila as kids. And they're making it happen now.
Yes.
That's the way I see
it.
Kumbaga, there are a 12-year-old kid who wants to see this shirt design. He doesn't have the means, doesn't have the manpower to do it. Tapos nag-turn siya into an adult and he's still carries the same slogans, so all in his memory is still fresh. Mm. And he wants it translated onto a shirt now that he can. So he does it for himself and sells it to his friends. Tas lalaki. And suddenly it becomes an empire. You can relate to that, I think, kasi you've been a music fan first and foremost, then you got into art, and then now that you have the knowledge to make it happen, these merchandise that you've dreamed of as a kid na wala, non-existent, gagawin mo ngayon, you make it happen. First and foremost for yourself, if it sells, then it's good. If it doesn't, well, fuck it. At least I did it, di ba? Yun naman ang ano eh. That's what I hear from software owners eh. Parang, I started that just for fun. We just still screened 20 pieces of shirts just for our friends and sold like 5 to some strangers. And then they posted it. And then kumalat. And suddenly, it's an empire. Suddenly, people are making a living out of it, which is really good. Alam mo yun? Parang these success stories are as inspiring as listening to stories of bands making it. These are individuals who are brave enough to tread unknown waters and come out successful. Like you, the best example I can come up with. Na I saw you lugging in a suitcase of shirts and a backpack and putting it on merch tables sa mga venues. Sa mga gigs. Alam mo yun? Oh, you did the work. Social media wasn't really big back then. Mm. So you had to do the legwork. You had to tour Manila, bring your shirts here, get kids crazy. Kumbaga, dati, ngayon, automatic, di ba? Tawag ko sa'yo dati, parang...
Madali na lang talaga ngayon eh.
Yun nga, nakakatawa nga kasi pangalan mo, Nick Automatic. But you've been doing things the manual way.
Yes, exactly.
Which is funny, di ba?
And actually, so thankful din ako na yun talaga yung... Ganun talaga yung setup dati. Kasi, extra knowledge din yan eh. Kasi I know some brand owners these days didn't experience that sort of stuff before na hindi pa grabe yung social media. Oh yes, organic talaga. Wala pang paid ads. Wala pang paid ads. Mga ganun. Wala pang influencers dati. Saka, hindi pa yan term.
Basically, you went through all the things required para maging streetwear brand. And you're still reaping the benefits of it. Our fans, some of our followers and fans way back aren't fans and followers anymore. Ngayon, some have matured, some have turned into pure businessmen, some of them are now into streetwear or into sneakers more than into bands. Pero may mga sasalo nun eh, may mga bata na naghihintay na, what? Regardless if it's old stuff or new stuff, may mga ganung bata eh, parang no, I don't want the newer stuff. I like the older stuff. Mm. I like the stuff from the 90s. May mga ganung mga bata eh, kasi since the internet is so wide na parang you can search for everything.
Yes,
hindi na rin pare-pareho yung hindi na rin pare-pareho yung opinion ng mga audiences eh. Hindi mo sila mailalagay sa pigeonhole eh, na parang this one category A listens to this, category B listens to this, and wears this. There can be a hip hop kid who raps for his music, yun ang genre niya as a performer. Pag-uwi siya ng bahay, he listens to Slayer and Metallica and because that's what his dad had him listen to as a kid. So parang ngayon,
hybrid.
Oh, someone into sneakers is not necessarily hip-hop. Doon ako naiinis eh. Parang when they say sneakerhead, dapat hip-hop. Parang sukang-suka na ako doon, pre. Kumbaga parang, how about, ang dami-daming metalheads na sneakerheads, sa totoo lang. And lagi na lang hip-hop yung mga napi-feature. And I'm like, parang you're not really paying attention. Ang dami-daming sneakerhead na metal kasi it came from skate culture. And all these rappers, hindi naman sila nang galing sa ganung background. Just because it's expensive, di ba? Parang they just need it for the Instagram feed or whatever. Exactly. They want to they just want to see people na they can afford it. I made it big, so I'll buy this shit even if I don't like it. Mm. Maraming ganun ngayon eh, kasi it's all attention grabbing now. Mm.
So, actually, bro, yung nakikita ko dati kasi with you, nung you keep on wearing SBs and Dunks, parang yun talaga yung tumatak sa utak ko dati. Yung parang, yun yung identity mo dati hanggang ngayon eh. Yung parang, you're that metal dude that wears these shoes, these kind of shoes, sneakerheads, into streetwear and everything. And I think it became your branding na talaga eh. Kaya nga parang na-fascinated ako doon na this guy established talaga this look talaga. So, yun. It's just my observation.
gets. Ay, talagang dati kasi medyo weird na nakikinig ka ng metal and you perform metal and you wear all these crazy shoes, di ba? Parang, I don't really wear them that much na sa stage, pero alam mo yun, parang I still collect them and I still treat them as works of art. Alam mo yun? Kumbaga, it's all part of my lifestyle and identity na parang I can't even name a person I copied na parang ito idol ko to, bibilin ko lahat ng sinusuot niya or bibilin ko lahat ng ng binibili niya. Parang hindi ganoon eh. I started ito kasi yun eh. Parang I idolized Pharrell Williams sa porma. Tapos I listened to hardcore. So idol ko si Jamie Jasta. Tsaka idol ko Pantera, si Phil Anselmo. Kumbaga, ang ginawa ko is, ang paniniwala ko kasi, not necessarily the way you dress is the way you sound. Kumbaga, it's not an image.
Exactly.
Kumbaga, it's not an image. It's all disjointed. It's all disjointed. The way I dress off stage is not necessarily what I wear on stage. Kumbaga, hinihiwalay ko siya. Lalo na ngayon, hinihiwalay ko siya talaga. Kumbaga, ngayon kasi sa Valley of Chrome, we are usually in black clothes on stage. So, hindi ako makakapag-streetwear masyado sa Valley of Chrome gigs, which is understandable because I respect us as a group.
Yes.
I won't bring my sneakerhead self on stage, which was dati the case, di ba? Ginagawa ko talaga siya dati. Pero yun, I can't deny it na it's really a part of who I am. Collecting sneakers, streetwear, tapos yung alam mo yun, that exciting part of collecting stuff like vinyl toys and action figures. You know that demographic talaga eh. Parang you coming from the same creative industry. May laruan ka na nga eh. Padala mo ako nun, ha?
Oo, sige. No problem.
Ang ganda nun. So, sabihan mo kung paano umorder.
So, bro, ano yung mga... You've been collecting sneakers, streetwears, and toys, and everything. So, is there any... Can you share to our viewers kung ano yung mga favorite brands na kinukolect mo talaga these days?
Ano kasi primarily talaga sa in terms of collecting sneakers talaga. Nike Dunks talaga, Nike SBs and Air Jordans. Yun talaga. Tapos ano, meron din akong part ng forma ko talaga na mahilig ako sa skate shoes at sa running shoes, which I was blessed, which we were blessed to have ano both sneaker deals with. Yung una is DC Shoes. DC Shoes Philippines. Ayun, may existing deal kami with Valley of Chrome. So I wear DCs. And I've been wearing DCs even before I was wearing Nike SBs. I was collecting DCs and skate shoes from the 90s. Tapos another one is Saucony. So Saucony Originals. So I also wore Sauconys. Kumbaga, kung hindi ako nakadunk, Value of Chrome kami. And if I wasn't in those, I was in skate shoes. I wore DCs, I wore Ethnies, I wore Vans sneakers. Kumbaga, wala rin naman akong, ano eh, hindi rin talaga ako talaga nagsistick sa isang brand. It just so happened na Nike talaga is parang pinaka kinokollect namin during that time eh. So, yun yung, kumbaga, ang saya nga eh, kumbaga parang I gotta show you this. Ayan. I got a yes. wall of wow. sneakers beside me. Medyo madilim pero. I got sneakers. Oh, so yun, parang siguro to sum it all up, I got the random Adidas Superstar, I got the random Converse. Mm. But yet the bulk of my collection is Nike and I wear Saucony and BC and some Vans on the side. Kumbaga halo-halo. The brands that sponsor us are understanding enough to know na you can't be just wearing one brand in your lifetime. Mm. They understand na correct. They understand the cool factor na a sneakerhead would wear Nike for 6 days straight and then suddenly wear New Balance on the next day. And it's still cool. Kumbaga, parang there's no accounting for taste. You don't chalk it up on a calendar na parang, so ganito, ganito lang lagi. Parang it's not that. Parang I could come out wearing loafers if I like. I could come out wearing slippers if I like. Kumbaga, it's all in the air na. Yes, if there's something black and red, bibigyan mo ako ng hush puppies. Nagkaroon ako ng Sperry. May binigay sa akin Sperry. Star Wars, pare. Oh, it's the Darth Vader colorway. It's got this special box. It's got the red soles. I wore it to our band friend John's wedding. I had the best shoes on. Like, fucking Darth Vader at a wedding, di ba?
Yes.
I had long sleeves on. Yeah, di ba?
And sa mga clothings din, ano yung prefer mo?
Clothing. Mm. There was a time I was so big into Supreme and Obey. Mm. Tapos, I also had a few pieces from Johnny Cupcakes. Gusto ko rin yun eh. Meron pa ba nun? Do you have that cupcake with the crossbones?
Actually, meron pa eh. Pero naiwan ko dyan sa Pinas. Kasi hindi nakasya sa akin eh. Parang lumalaki ako lalo. So,
pasa pero meron pa ako.
Sige, hanapin ko yun. Andami pa nun. Kasi palagi ako nag-order ng Johnny Cupcakes dati. Hindi na-fit sa akin eh.
Nag-aanap ako nun yung crossbones na cupcake. I used to have a couple of those. Pero hindi ko rin alam eh. Nawala ako sa gig or something. Pero gustong-gusto ko yun. Tapos, ano pa ba? Dali ah. Naalala ko talaga Obey. Ang dami kong Obey. Tapos Supreme. Tapos may mga Japanese brands din like W Taps. Mm. Tapos Neighborhood.
Neighborhood, yes.
Mga ganun. Parang I can't lie na parang hindi ko siya ino-order dati online. Parang talagang nag-uukay ako dati to find those. Kasi hindi pa siya ganun ka-popular dati. People were clueless basically on what Supreme was. Na parang ngayon, kung sino-sino nung nagsasalpak ng Supreme, yung mga cap na sobrang laki ng red logo. Di ba? Parang mapapaputang ina ka lang yun dyan eh. I still love Supreme. Kumbaga, someone game kasi umorder ako ng Travis Scott na sapatos. Tapos sabi niya, may kasamang regalo yan, pre. Tapos he packed in a shirt. Yun, Supreme na t-shirt, di ba? Mm. Nakakatawa yung isang pinadala niya sa akin, Supreme na shower cap, pre. Shower.
Bro, that's cool. Really, that's really cool, actually.
So, tawa ako ng tawa. Ano to, panliligo? It's on display dito sa kwarto, parang just for amusement, alam mo yun, parang shower cap, susuot ko to sa outfit ko.
Yung gusto kong bilhin, bro, sa Supreme, yung brick, kahit isang brick lang ilagay ko sa table ko, parang lang sa paper.
7,000 pesos ba yun?
Oh, shit, 7,000 man.
Pesos. Hindi ko lang alam, hindi ko masyado matanda, pero nakita ko parang $150 somewhere.
Ang mahal eh. Grabe.
Pero seryoso, gusto mo nun?
Oo, panglagay ko lang sa table, panglagay ko lang sa mga paper para hindi lumilipad yung paper. Di ba yung shower cap mo, paper. Anong purpose nun? Di pangligo. Ganon. May weight yung paper brick weight, eh. No? Paperweight. Pero cool siya kasi Supreme.
Mas may purpose pa nga yun. Oo nga. Tsaka ano, iniisip ko mga biruan, parang pwede gamitin yung shower cap ngayon, di ba? Parang daksin, oh, mga virus doon na pupunta sa buhok pag naglalakad.
Pero Supreme, yun talaga yung point eh ngayon. So, about local din, kasi mostly foreign yung pinag-usapan natin. May mga brands na eat, parang you prefer to wear locally, may mga brands ka na gusto mo, we can talk about it.
Alam mo, sa sobrang dami, baka pag nag-mention ako, baka may mga magtampo na hindi ko sila nabanggit. So, I'd rather say na, ano kasi ako eh, hindi ako brand purist. Halimbawa, merong ginawa yung certain brand na gusto ko yung t-shirt niya. Tapos, may isang brand na gusto ko yung hoodie niya. Gusto ko yung cap. Kumbaga, parang I treat every work of brand, individual works. Hindi ako brand loyalist. Kumbaga, bawa, someone hits me up na, yo, we're going to give you some merchandise. Parang ako, ang sasabihin ko talaga is, let me see. Don't send me a care package full of stuff. And I just pick 2 from 5. Parang ganun.
Sayang
lang. Dati ganun ako. Dati kasi ako parang medyo parang, sige, uy, padala mo lang. Tapos parang I end up not wearing everything. So, kumbaga, out of economy sake din, na parang, dude, patingin muna, tapos sasabihin ko sa'yo if I like, this one and this one. Para rin tipid. Para, so yun, in that way, nasi-streamline ko rin yung taste na parang, so yun, pero sasabihin ko rin sa'yo, sobrang ganda ng streetwear scene ngayon. Kaya lang minsan na lose in translation na rin yung meaning minsan. Kasi parang kung ano-ano na lang nilalagay sa mga t-shirts, sobrang predictable na. So parang nakita ko na to sa ganitong brand or nakita ko na to sa ganito, tas yung iba nagkokopyahan pa ng design. So parang minsan kasi nawawala na yung rason kung bakit mo gusto eh. Parang dati kaya gusto ko yung mga brand na ganito kasi nakikipag-usap siya sa akin. Tapos pag sinuot ko siya, reflection siya ng personality ko.
Yes, exactly.
Pero halimbawa, lahat ng brand magkakamukha na, tapos pare-pareho pa yung slogan, inalter lang yung 3 words sa isang sentence, tinalpak. Yung alam mo yun, minsan talaga maganda yung design pag binasa mo yung slogan, talaga parang di ko maintindihan kung anong gustong sabihin. Hindi ko susuot yun. Parang ganun. Kumbaga, parang these things are parang like songs. T-shirts are like songs to me. Parang they should, if there's a slogan, dapat may 'di ba? Parang when you have to explain it to your audience, parang people will understand it.
No audio.
Yan. Hello.
Hello, yan.
May kailangan ba ako ulitin?
Yes. Ba yun? Yung ano, yung parang t-shirts are like a song.
Oo, t-shirts are like songs. Kumbaga parang pagka in-explain sa'yo or nalaman mo yung meaning behind the shirt. Kumbaga, minsan dun ka pa mahuhulog eh. Dun ka matutuwa eh. Oo, parang if the creator explains it to you in such a way na parang you could relate to, dun ka pa one guy I really admire with that kind of stuff is Bobby Hundreds. Very,
yes.
Very articulate person. Matalino talaga siya eh. Kumbaga parang when he explains something, you get to feel what he feels. You empathize with him. Tapos you won't necessarily end up buying what he sells, but you will appreciate what he sells. That's what I like about the guy. Kumbaga, he's not just selling t-shirts, he's selling the experience behind the shirt. And kumbaga, ayun, yun yung masaya sa ganyan.
Actually, yun talaga yung gusto kong ipaabot sa mga brand owners kasi recently I've launched some motivational stuff for them and I'm trying to share my experiences then. So every time they ask me about how to start a clothing brand or how to polish your branding, how to sell, parang ganun. Nagsasabi talaga ako na kayo, mga brand owners, kailangan talaga kayo mag-tell ng story on bakit ganito yung brand mo, ano yung advocacy mo, what is it all about. Kasi yun yung kulang sa atin eh. Sa sobrang dami ng clothing lines ngayon, parang hindi mo na alam eh. Hindi mo na alam ano to eh. Might as well tell a story about it. It will add value kasi sa sino yung ano eh na tumitingin ng brand mo. Totoo yan. Yun yung lacking sa atin sa industry kasi, natin.
Ganon din kasi basis ko for sneakers eh. Alam mo yun? Parang I just won't buy a sneaker just because it looks good. Mm. Certain collaborations na parang I have to read about it. There was even this debate na parang a friend of mine was telling, binili ko to, hindi ko nga alam kung anong ibig sabihin nito eh. Tapos parang sabi ko, I don't do that. Sabi ko ganun, sabi ko, before it even slips on my foot or sets appearance in my collection, I should understand what's it all about or act, even have an idea kung ano man to. Alam mo yun? Parang I don't keep stuff I don't understand. Siguro mga 90% of stuff I own, if you take it out of my shelf, I could explain it as encyclopedic. Alam mo yun? So, yun. Kumbaga, parang one thing siguro, for your audience to understand you owe them an explanation, I think. Di ba? You owe them an explanation on what your product or your brand is all about. Kasi, if you're just selling this for the sake of selling, and it doesn't ring a chord with them, strike a chord with them, parang, they won't end up buying it. Or they would buy like one shirt and then forget about you and move on to the next brand.
Yes. Correct.
Because they don't feel a connection. A brand is like a friend. A brand is a friend. Kumbaga, if it speaks to you in volumes and there's some emotion na nararamdaman mo, you would probably end up going back to the same brand over and over again because yun nga nami-miss ko eh kasi di ba Nick Automatic dati was a movement kumbaga dati naalala mo yung interview ko sa'yo you were saying kids lining up ng madaling araw for a certain shirt di ba kumbaga yun yung nawala dahil because everything now is digital nawala yung community and the experience of meeting people because there's a certain shirt to be launched and you all had to be on neutral grounds, whatever, kung gaano karami yung bibili mo, ilang piraso ba bibilihin mo, ganyan-ganyan. Regardless if you're going to resell it or whatever, but the mere fact na nandun ka, and you're with these people, this community,
it's an experience. Something.
It's an experience. It's not just the shirt. Parang, it's like a gig shirt. It's like a Slayer shirt, Metallica shirt. I was there. Alam mo yun?
Exactly.
I was there, parang I saw them. I was in front row. They played this and that. May ganung.
This reminds me nung
ano. Guy and I saw this guy.
This reminds me nung pumunta ako ng Soundwave Festival sa ano, sa
Australia.
Sa Australia. Nanood ako noon. Tapos bumili talaga ako ng t-shirt kasi gusto ko ma-remind ako sa sarili ko na I had this experience and I like the design and everything. So, ganyan yung gusto kong i-embody sana sa mga brands na nag-dwell sa industry natin. And there's a story to tell. There's a connection. Diba?
Yun nga, natatawa ako, diba? Yung parang yung sa Bakken Open Air. Talagang bumili kami ng tig-isang t-shirt. Puta, magkano yun? Parang 2,000 ata.
Yung mga ganyan talaga yung price.
Pati yung Hammer Sonic, bumili rin kami nun kasi puto nandun yung logo namin, pre. Ngayon, di ba? Yung 2019 na Bakken, nandun yung logo namin. Tapos in-announce na naman ng Bakken. Di ba, lumabas kami sa online show. Tapos parang nilabas nila yung t-shirt, chinek kagad ng manager ni Jeff. tangin na men, nandito na naman tayo. Paano bibili niyan? Paano tayo bibili niyan? Parang pinaparaan na namin kung paano kami bibili. Just because ano, these shirts aren't just wearables. Eh. Parang there's a certain story. Kung halimbawa, naging basahan status na siya, kakasuot mo. Kutsa, ipakwadro mo, ipaframe mo.
Yes. Diba? Correct.
Ayan, may ganun akong tendency talaga eh, about certain things na parang, bawa, if it doesn't serve its purpose anymore, like certain shoe, like a Jordan 1 from 1985, gago ka kung isusuot mo pa rin yun ngayon, di ba? Parang, but it serves its purpose. It's a memorabilia. It has stories behind it. Someone wore it. Tapos ano, naipanglaro siya or naipang-skate. Those certain things na medyo pang-exhibit na yung dating eh. Pero for archival purposes, there may mga taong nagsusuot ng Supreme nung nag-uumpisa pa lang, na ngayon iba na yung forma, pero they still keep those things parang because it brings them back to a certain time where everything was much active and it meant more, alam mo yun. Ganun din yung mga hardcore band eh, mga merchandise ng mga hardcore bands nung, some people still hunt for those and pay serious dollars for them just because it brings them back to that certain period of time when everything was exciting and organic. Diba?
Kahit ako can, bro, nami-miss ko na din eh.
Para pag inisip.
Nami-miss ko talaga yung ganyan yeah. na feeling, yung organic talaga na feeling. Oh. Kasi mostly digital na yun.
Alam mo yung ba, may nilabas na sneaker, tapos pumila kami sa nag-raffle, tapos pumila kami, tapos ang aga-aga nandun na kami. You remember those things. Pero ngayon, pag sneakers nilabas, you just log on to a sneaker app and wait for kung nabunot yung pangalan mo. Oh. You can't really, halimbawa, naging 2000, year 2050 na or something. Tapos hindi mo naman sasabihin na, oh, those were my memorable days when I logged on to an app and they my name and I was jumping with joy. Alam mo yun?
Weird talaga siya.
Pero yung mga sneaker stories na, that weird. That dati, I was hanging out in 7-Eleven for like, a hat comes in and then say, hey, you're also lining up? Yeah! And then we hung out and then there was this group again and then suddenly we were 7 people and then we all lined up and then alam mo yun? Yung
ganyan na feeling.
Sneaker stories na, and sabi, that guy, you know that guy I hung out 10 years ago who bought this shoe, he's now a lawyer and he hooked me up. Mga ganun, di ba? Mga ganun. Yeah. Oh, you removed the human aspect of the consuming things now or buying things. That's what's lacking. So, parang, if anything, these brands should be more challenged to bring a more human element to these things when they're launching something online. How can they humanize the experience again? Diba? How do they bring back that organic element to the digital thing, which is very popular and which is the norm now? Kumbaga, if there's a new normal, this is the new normal. You buy stuff online, but yet there's something you miss. I don't know if kids could relate to that, pero they should experience it one way or another.
Yes.
And it's like dining in at a restaurant, di ba? You going into to a Italian restaurant, I'd say. Tapos you see the ambiance, you feel the ambience, you feel the table, the seat, how the food served. Unlike when it's delivered to your doorstep na naka-foil and styro and you open it, it's not the same. It
kulang the same, talaga. Kulang yung experience.
Sneakers. Sneakers, wala namang nagbago sa technology ng sneaker. When you wear a certain sneaker from 2001 and the sneaker from 2020, it feels the same, basically. Mm. But it's the how you got it and where you got it and what happened when you got it.
Yes.
Yun yung mga nagsiset apart ng mga ganun. Eh. Mm. And that's the reason why people have a very hard time parting with these things when they have to sell it because of some financial problem. It's not the shoe anymore, or it's not the shirt yes. anymore. It's that experience that tas binenta nila. Tapos
my story behind it.
Time na may pera na sila. Yeah, yeah. Oh, may ganun eh, may ganun. That's why alam mo, yung Netflix na series ni Michael Jordan was so big because all these people could remember the time when they watched it first, those games, and when they saw Michael Jordan in those shoes.
Nostalgic. Kumbaga,
oh, it's not the end product anymore that ano that you get. Parang it's more of those feelings that come up when you touch something. That's why people still buy books kahit may online version ng books. Diba? Because you can touch those things, you can feel the cover, you can... Kaya nga vinyl is so big again, vinyl records. Diba? Plaka? That's why. You can't feel a Spotify song or an MP3.
Yes.
Diba? Yeah. It's a different feeling when you physically touch the finished product. So, yun. Mga ganun. Yun talaga min.
So, before we close out this podcast, yeah. Kasi there's a lot of stuff that we can go on the whole day.
Oh, naman.
Pero, parang we need to come to a conclusion talaga sa to sum it up all na pinag-usapan natin na from heavy metal to streetwear to to how the world runs in retail or interesting talaga yung pinag-usapan natin.
Dami na rin okay. Dami na.
Dami na talaga. We can go all day but we need to close out our podcast kasi we have our lives also. Any advices for fellow musicians or any type of industry na involved on our topic? Any advices for them? Mga motivational quotes. Mga ganun.
Alam mo, I've been dwelling on this for the past few days din. Parang this pandemic parang brought a moment of clarity at least for me na parang it's not about the individual or the creator or the artist na parang kasi ngayon dude nawala yung mystique ng pagiging artist kasi it's all on social media. People know what you ate for lunch, people know what you did in the morning. People, you type in a name of a celebrity, nakikita mo kung anong ginawa niya for the day or nakita mo yung paborito mong artista, nakipag-reunion kay ganito. Parang nawala yung mystique dati. I don't have an idea what Metallica does in the morning, dude. Wala akong alam. I thought Metallica ate goat heads for breakfast when I was a kid. Sabi ko, ganun ba sila kasatanista? So that's a challenge for us all na parang to keep a certain amount of mystique to everything na parang I know it's hard and I'm also dealing with it pero siguro ang bottom line is me personally, I'm speaking for me, I'd rather be known for the songs I make and the performances we do as a band than to be known as parang as an individual, parang pucha, biruan nga namin eh kung sabi ko kung na-discover pa na lalaman natin in advance na makikilala yung banda natin, sabi ko sana na-suggest ko nakamaskara na lang tayo eh. kasi mas parang mas gusto kong tanggalan ng mukha yung tugtog, mas gusto ko pang pakinggan mo yung mga kanta namin as it is, sans the imagery, remove the image, take away the showbiz stuff away from this music kasi mas gusto ko siya treated as art itself eh. Parang may pinost ako days ago eh na parang sinasabi ko, 'di ba, may magandang bahay. Tapos may lalapit sasabihin ang ganda ng bahay, hindi mo naman itatanong kung sino yung carpintero, 'di ba?
Oh.
'Di ba? Sasabihin mo lang, ang ganda ng bahay. Tapos itong bahay na 'to, maraming itira dito, maraming henerasyon na makikintero. Hindi mo naman Procopio ganito gumawa niyan. Hindi naman ganoon, 'di ba? Alam mo lang, napakagaling ng karpinterong 'to at ang ganda ng bahay na nagawa niya. Malamang dedo na siya. Hindi ko alam pangalan niya, pero tangina, ang galing ng karpinterong 'to. Dapat ganoon din natin. Gusto ko ganoon ako i-treat ng bilang musikero na parang ang ganda ng mga kanta niya. Wala na akong pakialam kung kilala mo pangalan ko. Siguro kung alam mo Valley of Chrome bilang banda as a collective. Kutsa, masaya na ako. Wala akong pakialam kung di mo kilala. As me.
Wow.
Mas gusto ko alam mo pa yung lyrics ng kanta ko kaysa alam mo kung anong kinain ko nung almusal. Ganun. So yun lang naman. Kasi digital age talaga ngayon took away the mystery of everything. Yun lang naman. Kumbaga, na-admire ko nga yung mga tao who can afford to stay away from social media for so long. Ako kasi hindi ko kaya because it's my job. It's a part of my job.
Actually, it's the same for me naman talaga. Ako talaga parang naging toxic na talaga yung social media. So much more they keep on talking about political shit. So toxic na talaga, and I wanted to stay away from it, pero hindi ko kaya kasi there's business into it as well. And we need to live, di ba?
You have that responsibility.
Yes.
It's also an avenue na parang maganda siya kung magagamit mo siya ng tama. I'm also guilty of being toxic sometimes, and I have to step back. Sometimes I post something and then I delete it after 2 minutes just because I feel na parang no, you don't need to know this side of me, or you don't need to know my opinion. My opinion doesn't really matter. It's as good as the next guy's. Alam mo yun? Parang it's not what I want you to remember me for. Di ba? Alang, I'm guilty of posting opinions about politicians and stuff like that, and then I end up deleting it kasi naiisip ko parang meron akong opinion, but then my opinion is as important as the next guy. So alam mo yun, I'd rather talk it out during having coffee with someone I personally know. Yes. Di ba? So, and instead of posting about it blatantly, I'd rather put it into art. Rather make it a song, which is what I'm heavily doing right now. The new songs are basically me talagang saying everything on my mind. And my mind is not a pretty place. So yun. So I'd rather translate it onto art. You will read ugly stuff for the new material, but I can say it's 100% true. Ito yung pinakatotoong mga news. Yung mga news songs namin talaga, medyo naging no holds barred ako rito eh. I'd rather let my music do the talking than what would you rather hear, diba? A musician playing music or a musician just talking his ass out on social media? I'd rather listen to your music and what you have to say, diba?
Wow.
I don't want Axl Rose to talk about politics. I'd rather hear him sing on a new Guns N' Roses album. Diba?
Exactly.
Ganun lang.
Right. It's really great. Ang grabe, overwhelmed talaga ako sa pinag-usapan natin. Ang daming pointers na maganda. Talagang
umikot-ikot na tayo.
Informative naman talaga siya. Informative talaga siya, as in from your point of view, kasi yun din yung purpose ko. Bakit you're in this show din, kasi I want to pick your brains. What can you say about this stuff and everything, your thoughts. So I'm really interested and I'm really thankful for you, Rohel, for being in the lunch break. So I'm so honored with you.
Same. Parang I just want to say before we close this show na parang you are one of the people na nakita ko from the ground up. I saw you grind your way up, dude. Na nakita ko talaga na way back how you did things, and na parang I hold you in high regard as one of the most persevering creative people I know. So it's an honor to be a part of your show, and thank you for picking my brain as much as I picked yours. Salamat.
Thank you so much. Is there any you want to promote to our viewers? Any upcoming albums, songs, new singles?
We are in the process of making the new album, which we don't know when we will release it. Parang it all depends on. It's all up in the air right now, but definitely expect something from Valley of Chrome, and then we also have some pre-recorded shows which we did. Some weeks ago, which will eventually be released on Numinous TV. We got a couple of songs. Tapos ano, if you haven't, please do check out our Vakin spot, which we posted on YouTube. The whole thing, you can check that out. May storytelling kami ron about what happened and a couple of songs that we played live. Yon. Thank you so much.
Guys, follow Valo of Chrome on their YouTube channel as well. Follow them on all of their social platforms. Again, we're going back to the digital stuff. But wala tayong magawa dyan. So,
wala. We can only adjust.
Rohel, thank you so much for being in the lunch break. It's an honor. And hopefully, maka-release pa tayo ng marami pang albums for Valley of Chrome despite this freaking pandemic. Sana matapos na din to. Looking forward for more materials for Valley of Chrome talaga. As in, big fan talaga ako nung ano, nag-shift kayo definitely sa Tagalog songs, which is wow! They did it, guys. Parang naka-ganun talaga ako. So, props to you guys for doing this, and thank you so much.
Salamat.
And guys, thank you for hanging out at the lunch break. Be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more. There's a couple of episodes coming up. We will go back to the topic of design and businesses again. And if you like this video, please do give us a thumbs up. If may gusto kayong mga questions for Rohel or questions for me, please put it in the comments below. May mga suggestions kayo or may mga comments kayo about yung mga pinag-usapan namin, put it in the comments below, and see you on the next video. Thank you, guys.